Live from New York City, it's theCUBE. Here is your host, Jeff Frick.
Hi, Jeff Frick here. We're on the ground at the USS Intrepid. It's Hadoop on the Hudson. Big Data Week in New York City, StrataConf, Hadoop World, and of course our event, Big Data NYC. But this is the place to be tonight. This is a great party. The USS Intrepid Air and Space Museum. A lot of cool planes, spaceships, helicopters, and of course the aircraft carrier. So I'm joined here by Chris Selland, who's probably relieved not to be running this event.
Yeah, exactly. It's nice to kind of be a guest for once, so yeah, absolutely. This is a great event, though.
So last we saw you was at your customer event at the Vertica show. So
actually, last you saw me was at the Tableau event.
Oh, the Tableau event. Yeah, I wasn't
exactly
there.
Okay, so that's why you didn't see me there.
So give us a quick update. What's been going on?
So, you know, we're here at Strata. I mean, it's a great week to be in New York. This is kind of the industry buzz. We got a lot of new stuff coming out. You know, it's what we're always doing. We're really focused on our customers. We're really focused on, you know, kind of what our customers doing, making them successful, working with our partners. We got a bunch of partners here. We've obviously got Matt Barr here. We've got Voltage here. We've got SyncSort here. We've got Talent here. So this has been a great event. And, you know, this is really where the industry is this week. So I guess some people are Dreamforce, but to me, you know, this is really where it's at. So
Greg and I were at Dreamforce on Monday.
How are you? Okay, so you get to do both.
We're all over the place. Yeah, yeah. The CUBE is everywhere.
Well, you know, I love Benioff, but you know, we're 3,000 miles away. I couldn't be happier.
Yeah.
So
he was all about. Mark. He was all about giving away 3 million meals.
There you go.
Which is pretty cool.
Their Dreamforce cares. Amazing job. So
I think 145,000 people. So you guys can get the Vertica event up to 145. You know, something to shoot for.
We're working on it. Exactly.
Well, it really feels good that you know the Hadoop thing, if you will, the big data thing is so far past POCs now. Mm-hmm. We're really getting into a lot of production.
Yeah.
Seeing ROI, Jack was talking about some studies they released about ROI, and again, just really unleashing some tremendous data, value, business value with these tools.
Yep. Well, you know, this has always been, and that's a very good point, because this has always been kind of a, I don't know, I don't want to offend anybody, but this has always been kind of like a geek show. I mean, Strata's always been very hardcore technology, and I think you started seeing this about a year ago, and you're really seeing it now, is, you know, I always cite the book Crossing the Chasm, sort of shows how old I am, but, you know, the reality is that's what most of the customers are looking for these days, and that's what the whole kind of idea that, you know, cross the chasm, right, get past the technology. It's not about the speeds and feeds anymore, the scalability, or petabytes or zettabytes or what have you. It's about the business value.
Right.
It's about show me how to use this stuff to help move my business forward. And there's a whole lot of, you know, I always talk about my business to make money, but there's so many like public sector, government things going on as well. So there's so much cool stuff going on with big data these days, but it's really about the value.
Right.
It's not like it makes the technology less important, but it puts it in context.
Right. I mean, we had a guy on at Splunk.com last week talking about, you know, a 1% fuel savings in his locomotives. Mm-hmm. by better managing all the control systems is $1 billion.
Mm-hmm.
Right. That's unlocking some good value.
Small things make a big difference, but when you look at sort of the GDP contribution that the McKinsey's and the Bain's of the world, you know, it's like in the trillions of dollars of value. It was in the Wall Street Journal this week. It was something like $12 trillion of value potentially to be unleashed by unlocking big data and figuring out how to use it more intelligently. And so that's really what we're hearing about this week.
And yeah, we're still in the early innings, right?
Absolutely.
We're still in the early innings.
Absolutely.
All right, well, Chris, thanks for stopping by. We just grabbed him off the aircraft carrier.
Right.
Again, Jeff Frick here.
I was trying to climb in a plane. I was going to get in trouble.
You'll get in trouble.
It's good. You kept me out of
trouble.
Glad we
rescued you.
Yep.
We're on the ground at the USS Intrepid Air and Space Museum on the Hudson. It's Hadoop on the Hudson, Big Data Week, New York City. I'm Jeff Frick. You're watching theCUBE.